Hello, my name is Matthias. I'm a software engineer at Synedia, working on NATS. NATS is the networking abstraction to finally free you and your apps from networking and the silos that plague us all. It allows you to refocus on your data and its flows on a global scale. We have recently added Jetstream, our persistence layer. This video is about Jetstream at the edge. Our servers are lightweight and can therefore run in resource-constrained environments. This allows you to have persistence on a remote edge and have it function independently without connectivity to the cloud. If you want to, you can configure Jetstream such that your locally persisted data is automatically uploaded to the cloud as soon as you regain connectivity. This applies specifically to cases where the edge itself moves in and out of network connectivity, or when you have a great number of sites and are guaranteed a network outage at any given time. Depending on your needs, you would install one or more Jetstream-enabled server in your edge site and connect them to server in the cloud using leaf node connections. This is going to be a whirlwind tour through features and use cases. Do not focus on every detail. Please focus on what our software can do and which use cases are relevant to you. I will provide further links at the end. Before I start, I want to apologize for the audio quality. I had to filter, cut and edit quite a bit. I'm working from my apartment in New York and can read the ads inside the elevated metro line right outside my second floor window. In this video, I want to introduce the leaf node setup used here, talk about the implications of having the system account in a leaf node remote, introduce the concept of Jetstream domains, use stream mirrors to connect a command and control stream across Jetstream domains, use stream source to aggregate streams across Jetstream domains, demonstrate that Jetstream domain connectivity is not tied to the underlying topology, and connect streams through accounts. This is the topology of my setup. There is a central cluster to which two clusters, Spoke 1 and Spoke 2, connect via leaf node connections. I'm using two of these to demonstrate the principle, but you can have as many as needed. To show it's possible, each cluster consists of three servers. Use fewer if you do not need the redundancy. Let's have a look at server 1 in the cluster hub. This is your regular cluster and leaf node setup. Jetstream has a new property called domain. I'll be talking about this in a moment. Enabling multi-tenancy, accounts are the secure NATS isolation context. Unless explicitly defined, connections belonging to one account cannot communicate with connections belonging to another. Because of this, we generally recommend one account per application. However, their scope is up to you. In addition, this is an operator setup and uses the NATS account resolver to retrieve accounts. Instead of defining an account in every server, we provide a way to obtain it instead. On connect, the client provides a web token carrying user permissions as well as a proof of possession of a corresponding private key. After the account web token is downloaded, the chain of trust, operator signs account token, account signs user token is verified and all relevant limits and settings are applied. What I will be demonstrating in this video also applies when you configure your accounts in server config files. Leaf nodes are clustered as well. Although leaf nodes bridge authentication domains, if you have the same operator setup on either end and connect system accounts, it will appear to you as one large authentication domain. You could use such a setup, for example, when you can't use supercluster due to firewall rules and have to use leaf node connections instead. Another benefit of connecting system accounts is that you can obtain monitoring information from every server in this network. Here you can see all the leaf nodes as well. However, if you should connect system accounts, heavily depends on your security needs. This is exactly what was done here. The first remote connects the system accounts, the second remote connects the account we will be using. If you have the system account connected, but no domain specified, this is the Jetstream topology you'd get. This is a single Jetstream spanning all of our clusters. Jetstream has a metadata leader that is in charge of creating and placing streams and consumer. In a hub spoke setup like the one here, this metadata leader will be pinned to server that have no leaf node remote specified, meaning the hub. This avoids having a leaf node server become a leader and thus forcing other leaves to take two hops to get to it. But while leaf node connections are down, in the affected server, you could not create streams or consumer during the time. However, if you specify a Jetstream domain in your configs, each domain will become an independent Jetstream. My config will result in this topology. If you do not connect system accounts, this will be the resulting topology as well. Presence of domains cuts off certain system account traffic along leaf node connections and makes Jetstream addressable by domain name. The part I want to show you now is how to connect these independent Jetstreams. On the left, I'm starting a watch command that repeatedly executes three nets commands. This command is our Swiss Army knife. Among other things, it can be used to publish and subscribe, interact with Jetstream and generate various reports. It supports a context that can be set once and subsequently reused. Here, each invocation of Nets uses a context that uses appropriate credentials and connects it to the corresponding cluster. This will be my primary tool to show you what happened. Right now, there are no streams yet. One way to connect streams across Jetstream domains would be to have a command and control stream, essentially to communicate from the hub to each spoke without loss, even when leaf nodes are disconnected. We have a stream called CNC and it is subscribing to a subject by the same name. This stream is located in the hub. Its content is then mirrored to a receive CNC stream located in each node. Streams offer a variety of settings like storage backend, various limits, etc. I will only give arguments for values I want to be changed. Here stream replica count and subject to subscribe to. This way I can quickly go through the questionnaire. Let's also store a few messages. In each leaf node cluster, I want a stream named receiveCNC that is a mirror of the CNC stream. The output option causes NATS to store the settings in a file. Here, I'm essentially saying yes to import from a different domain, and I specify the domain name hub to import from. Now I'm creating that stream in each domain. It is important to point out that names do only need to be unique within a Jetstream domain. On the left-hand side, you can see the streams created and that our receive CNC streams already copied all data from CNC. Doing this the other way around, collecting data in the spokes and aggregating them in a stream in the hub is possible as well. In each spoke Jetstream domain, I am going to create a stream named test that subscribes to the subject test. Again, I stored the output so I can now easily create the stream multiple times. Please note that I created the streams in the respective domain while having been connected to the hub. If you want to interact with a Jetstream that is not in the domain you are connected to, you can provide a Jetstream domain option. This can also be set in the context. Let's also send 10 messages. As you can see, the messages sent while connected to the hub appear in both streams. This is because they use the same subject. Jetstream domains do not constrict message flow. If you're using a non-overlapping set of subject names in each domain, this won't happen to you. Same if you're using a different set of accounts in each domain. Later, I will show a third way of doing this. Of course, this also applies when you connect to a spoke as well. Now let's create a stream named aggregate, sourcing these streams. Here I have to specify which domain to source from, spoke 1 and spoke 2. Yes, to import from a different domain, the domain name is spoke-1. And similar for the domain spoke-2. Here we have our stream aggregate. It contains 40 messages with 20 messages from test in spoke 1 and 20 messages from test in spoke 2. Let me also demonstrate that the source and mirror stream relationships do not have to align with the underlying topology. Now I'm going to create a backup of the stream test in spoke 1. The backup itself is located in spoke 2. Now, let's send 10 more messages. Here, backup in spoke 2 has the same amount of messages as test in spoke 1. Let's quickly demonstrate that this works the way I explained by shutting down all server in the cluster hub. Here, our watch command for the hub can't connect any longer. See, there's a difference in message counts, until I start the hub again. There we go. Upon restart and reconnect, the messages got copied. Until now, we have exchanged streams across Jetstream domains, but we stayed in the same account. Now, let me show you how to exchange stream data across accounts. This will largely be an exercise in maintaining prefixes to avoid subject overlaps. I'm using NSC to create accounts and users and modify them. Because I'm using the Nets account resolver, when done, I can simply push my changes into the network. The NSC directory is in the same directory as where my servers got started. Part of my config just uses the creds files in the NSC keys directory. I did this so that for this demo I have everything in one place without having to copy files around. However, the power of our JWT-based approach is that you can have that in NSC environment anywhere, provided you can connect to push. Everything will work just the same. The commands I show next can be translated into accounts in regular config files as well. The account test is the account we have been using so far. We want to mirror the stream aggregate that we just created into a stream named cross-acc. Mirroring that particular stream allows the importing stream in the other account to be independent of the actual number of spokes. But first, we need another Jetstream-enabled account and user. Here, I created the account, enabled Jetstream, created a user. To connect our accounts, we need to export the consumer API needed when using Mirror. The advantage of copying the data from one account into another is that this avoids having to explicitly create a consumer for one account in another. The other advantage is that you don't have to write and run a program that does the copying. Here, we are exporting the consumer API as public service with a stream as response, meaning more than one message as a response. This can also be done as private export, which requires a token signed by the exporting account for the importing account. Therefore, you have precise control on who can import. You can also export the entire Jetstream API by exporting $js.hub.api.greater than. If you were to do so, you are giving full control over Jetstream to everyone importing. I export $js.hub.api instead of $js.api. This is so that I can pin access to a particular Jetstream domain and not just use the one where I connect to. On import, we change $js.hub.api to js.test@hub.api. This is done to stay clear of the $js prefix, which may get additions as new features are added to Jetstream. We give it a different prefix and subsequently specify that prefix if we want to talk to that particular Jetstream. By the way, this import renaming feature is generally available. Different organizations working on different applications most likely have different naming schemes. So when they clash, just rename on import. As long as the same number and types of wildcard are present, you're good. Also, reordering of wildcards would be possible too, but that's for another time. We also need a subject to deliver our data on. It is important to note that the subject we will be using in a bit is a lot longer than that. Essentially, each mirror will need a unique subject. I'm picking a common prefix here and subsequently will be adding parts. On import, the importing account's name is added. And now we push our changes so they're uploaded to the network. NSC also has a command to output account export import relationships as plant UML file. We generate the diagram, process it with plant UML, and show the generated PNG. This usually gives a better overview of the relationship between accounts. When creating the mirror, I have to import from a different account. We also specify the prefix we set on import and add the stream name to our delivery subject. The API prefix is what we change the API on import to. This is so we can differentiate between our Jetstream and the Jetstream in another account, in possibly the same domain. For the delivery prefix, we need to add the stream name. Just consider, what if I wanted to mirror the same stream twice? This is where the stream name helps to differentiate. Let's have a quick look at our new streams report. To do so, I'm using our new account's user credentials, which overrides the ones set in the context. Here you see, the new mirror already has all messages from before. While we recommend exchanging stream data via source and mirror, essentially copying, I have to show you how to share direct access of a durable pull consumer as well. Since I already have exports in test, I briefly clean them up to avoid warnings about overlapping subjects. What needs to be exported as service responding with a stream is the consumer's next subject. The next subject consists of the prefix, with domain, consumer, message, next, stream name, and durable consumer name. On import, we rename $js.hub.api to a different prefix, say from.test.api. To acknowledge messages, the ACK API needs to be exported and imported as well. We do so without name changes. And now we push our changes. And finally, we create the consumer dir that we already referenced in our exports and imports. Consumer add stream name, durable consumer name, type pull consumer, deliver all messages in the stream. On the left-hand side, our stream already has an increased consumer count. To consume, I'm overriding the credentials specified in the context. This is the user we created just now. Consumer, next message, stream, durable, and this is the important bit, js-api prefix. For that, we use the API prefix from.test.api that we set on import. And now we get our message. Let's briefly look at what would be necessary to do in a program. Similar to the CLI, we specify API prefix in line 20. Due to the very specific export, this program only has limited Jetstream API access. Therefore, nats.bind in line 27 provides stream and durable name explicitly, so the client doesn't have to look them up. Let's run it, connecting to the hub and using our new user. There you go. Messages are directly received from a durable in another account. Finally, I want to show you an account setup that addresses the same subject issue mentioned earlier. You will be able to use the same account in each leaf node and isolate it such that you don't have to worry about cross-traffic. This will clearly increase the complexity of your setup, so only do that if it otherwise makes your life simpler. Essentially, we will selectively connect subjects in our accounts through a dedicated Exchange account. We will be needing a name that identifies a leaf node or leaf node cluster uniquely. As I am demonstrating Jetstream, I am using domain names for that. However, you are not limited to Jetstream and any of your subjects can be connected in a similar way. This image shows the direction leaf to hop, but the setup I'm showing next only needs two extra imports to enable the other direction as well. So let's create these accounts. I'm creating the exchange account and the user, no Jetstream on purpose, leaf account with Jetstream enabled and the user, hub account with Jetstream enabled and the user, and I'm pushing all of that. Let's briefly change our watch command on the left to make use of our new users. I'm connecting to the hub, hub account, user, stream report, spoke, leaf account user, stream report, second spoke, same as first. We have no streams defined yet, which is why the commands are empty. Furthermore, only put the exchange account into the remotes. Not listing the other accounts is what isolates them from the hub and each other. I've looked up the account ID earlier using NSC list keys. A side effect of only having the exchange account in the remotes is that you can control access via exports and imports that can be pushed by NSC. You do not have to touch remotes in a config going forward. To demonstrate this, I pushed accounts without any exports and imports already. Right now, I have to restart NAT server so that the leafnode remotes change is picked up. Now we are connecting the accounts. Selectively, we export subjects we want to be able to send to and receive from in other accounts and domains. For every domain and account I wish to connect, I'm exporting the entire domain-specific Jetstream API as well as a delivery subject. You can also add dedicated subjects to communicate with regular NATs. For every account, I export a delivery subject containing account name and domain, as well as the Jetstream domain-specific API. All these exports are then imported into the exchange account. Please note that every subject already contains a fixed portion that functions as a type, the exporting account name, as well as the domain, in that order. Where this is not the case, such as the Jetstream API, I remap accordingly. This allows us to properly identify streams and services in an account in a leaf node as identified by its domain. Then we re-export all subjects together. This is where the type comes in handy with type.greaterthan. Finally, import into every account you want connected. I'm more specific than in the previous export, as I need to avoid a self-import cycle with, say, deliver.hubacc.greaterthan. If you want to be more specific and pin an import to a domain, just add it. And then we upload the changes. Then we create a stream in each leaf domain using the domain configuration test from earlier. Because it is possible, I can do so by connecting to the hub using hub account credentials. A domain essentially means we use the prefix $.js.domain.api when connected to the hub, because I imported $.js.leafacc.spoke-1.api and I neglected to avoid $.js, I can use the domain name leafacc.spoke-1 in the NAT CLI. There we go, streams are created. Now I publish messages to each leaf cluster using credentials for the leaf account. Because of the isolation, the messages stay in the domain they originated in. Every stream contains 10 messages. As a final test, let's connect to the hub using the same credentials. These messages will not be received because of our isolation scheme. The message count is unaltered. Now, let's create the importing stream inside the hub and the hub account. I am importing from a different account with the prefix $js.leafacc.spoke-1.api. The delivery prefix is deliver.leafacc.spoke-1.hubacc.hub.aggregate. Similar for Spoke 2. About the delivery prefix. You are essentially creating a stream that copies from one account in a domain to another account in another domain. Thus, I'd recommend that the delivery prefix consists of all these parts. Type from account, from domain, to account, to domain, importing stream name. There you go. It's already working. See on the left-hand side. Please be aware that it does not matter that the hub is actually a hub. I want you to take away that you can chain accounts and connect through them. Just think of a scenario where you have multiple leaf nodes into an NGS account, collecting data locally. One of your leaf nodes is spec bigger, and this is where you aggregate streams and do all your analytics. One thing I hope you noticed is the lack of hostnames and the flexibility that gives you. Of course, they are needed in the server configuration to create the NATS network. They are also needed to connect to that network, but you don't need different ones for each of your applications. Instead, you get to focus on your data and how it flows. We will continue to add improvements to the setups and workflows introduced in this video. I certainly have noticed a few rough edges, so it is worthwhile checking back every once in a while. This is it for today. I hope you find this video informative. If you have questions, reach out on our Slack channel on netsio.slack.com. Bye.